Hello, welcome back to Mark's House and Garden UK. This is Canna Musifolia, and sadly, it's got the Canna Virus. In this video, I'm going to talk to you about the Canna Virus, and I've had this plant for about 3 years. By now, it should probably be up here. But the Canna Virus has caused it to be stunted, and it's also had an effect on the leaves. So I'm going to talk to you about what I've learnt about Canna Virus. And there are three different types, roughly. Now this is Musifolia, but the virus does affect all Cannas. And I have other Cannas in this border, so I'll tell you how it spreads as well. I'll also tell you where they think it's come from and how it's become so prevalent. And what you can do about it, but it's not good news. All my Canna Musifolia is coming out. I have another Canna Musifolia over there which is not yet infected, and fingers crossed if I remove this one it won't become infected. But I'll be able to take a leaf off the non-infected one and compare it to a leaf off the infected one and show you the difference. This is going straight into the normal refuse bin, not the garden waste bin, because that's apparently what you've got to do with it. You're either supposed to burn it on site or put it in the general waste, not the garden waste, because it should not go into composting because the virus can be spread. So I'm going to take it all out and tell you what I know about the Canna Virus. I've got to be careful down here because I don't just have cannas in this border. I've got a tetrapanax, a colocasia, some gingers, and a euchemist bicolor. Fortunately, the Canna Virus is not transmissible to those other plants, but I'm being careful because I don't want to cause any damage. I suppose the nice thing about removing these cannas is it will let more light in. Everything I share with you in this video, I will type up in the description box below this video, and I'll also reference two very helpful resources which I found about the Canna Virus. There are three different types: Canna Yellow Mottle Virus, Canna Yellow Streak Virus, and Bean Yellow Mosaic Virus. These two on the left hand side of this piece of paper only affect cannas. The Bean Yellow Mosaic Virus can also affect cannas, beans, peas, freesias, and gladioli. Again, I'll type that up below. So, the Canna Virus that I've got here can be transmitted to the other cannas I have in my border. And I did intend leaving it to see if it would recover. But having read about it, it's not good news. It's not going to recover, and there is no cure. So the best thing you can do with virus to cannas to stop the virus from spreading into your other cannas and also to stop it spreading into other gardens is get them out and put them in your general refuse bin. How does it get to other gardens? Well, they use a term called vectors. What's a Canna vector? Well, a vector basically is the way it spreads, and it spreads by aphids, and it's in the sap. So the aphid comes along and nibbles on the canna and gets some of the sap, and then it moves to another one and transmits it. So it could transmit throughout my border, but if that aphid somehow manages to go to another garden, it could transmit it to another garden. And if that gets propagated and moved to another garden, it makes the virus much more easier to spread. And that's how they think it's spread. They think that it's spread through commercial canna production. Now, you would think that commercial producers of plants would have some kind of legislation in place for plant security. And indeed, now there is the plant passporting system. So you're not allowed to sell or move plants commercially, even inside the UK, without issuing a plant passport, and that's for plant and soil security. But back in the day when Canna Virus is thought to have started, which is sort of 2000, 2001, 2002. There wasn't any legislation about ornamentals, and cannas are classed as ornamentals. So these commercial canna growers that were importing thousands and thousands of these and exporting them all around the world, there were no controls. So commerciality kind of took over from plant security, and hence the canna virus spread. I've already mentioned that it's spread by aphids and in the sap, but it can also be spread by nematodes in the soil. So if you dig up one and give it to a friend, you can spread the virus. Right, I'm going to get in here and take the tops off these viruses, virus cannas. Then I'm going to take a leaf off one of the virus cannas and compare it to a leaf from another Musifolia over there so that you can see the difference. I've also got some beautiful footage of this canna a couple of years ago before it was infected, and I'll show you that as well. I've mentioned that there's no cure for canna virus, but there are ways in which you can prevent it and prevent it from spreading. I will run some footage of this in the corner of the screen whilst I show you some footage of this canna when it was looking really good a couple of years ago. And I'll also read these little tips. So the tips basically are: buy healthy plants. When you're looking at a plant in a garden centre, look at the leaf quality and make sure it's not got any mottling. And I'll show you what it looks like in a moment, but you're looking out for some key signs. Remove or destroy. Remove and destroy any infected cannas. Right down to the roots, dig them out. Get rid of them, because don't forget the nematodes could be spreading the disease. Always use clean tools, and never use a tool that you've used on a virus canna straight into a non-virus one. Pretty obvious, but you might just forget, so disinfect your tools between use. And I've already mentioned that it's transmitted by aphids, nematodes, and propagation. So get rid of them. Now, you can propagate cannas from seed, and it's felt that the virus does not propagate from seed. So if you've got some seed from an old infected plant and you grow it, the chances are that will be okay. Interesting facts about cannas is they were originally grown as starch crops before they became ornamentals. And the seeds, which are very hard and black and round, have been used to create jewellery necklaces, which I thought was an interesting fact. And one of the cannas is called Black Shot because of that. I remove this one, I've got one down there to go at, and I've got this clump here to go at. Then I've got to dig out the roots. I mean, I suppose the benefit from that is it will get let more light into these other beautiful plants, and I'll show you these plants in a moment. And it'll always also give me the opportunity to plant something more in here. I'm just going to get rid of these, dig out the roots, and then come back to you and show you the difference between a leaf of an infected one and a non-infected one, so that you know what to look for. I have to say, I do feel slightly sad doing this. All these cannas have been with us for a few years. I used to have them in pots in my previous house, and they all came from one clump and one pot, so it's a very sad day this for me, but unfortunately, needs must, and out they come. You can see here, I'm bringing out a big clump there. Underneath there, I expect to see lots of roots, and then if you break them up, you have these starchy roots. And in the old days, that was the food crop. Anyway, all that now is destined for the bin, along with all the rest of it in my border. So that's all of it removed, and the tools I've used are going to get sanitized in hot soapy water, and you can see there's a lot of it there. But because there's a lot of it there, there's now a lot of space here. And I've got a foxtail lily and some lovely gingers and a tetrapanax down there, which was a pup off another tetrapanax I had, and a colocasia escalenta. So this space will give them more light and more room to grow. I've also noticed they've got some little baby colocasia pink chinas down here as well. So there is a positive there to this. I'm going to take these gloves off now, as they may also be contaminated. And I'm going to go over to the other side of the border and remove using a completely clean set of secateurs, an uninfected leaf. And I'm going to take an uninfected leaf and an infected leaf over to the table where I can show you the difference. All the tools you see me use, by the way, the fork, the loppers, the secateurs, and the gloves are available in my Amazon shop. I'll put links below. If you buy anything, I do get commission. It all goes back into the garden, and your support is very much appreciated. Right, let's go and get an uninfected leaf. It's down here behind this huge tetrapanax. Let me just go in there and I shall get an example of a leaf which has not been infected with the virus, and you can see the difference. Same plant, same conditions, not virused, virused. What you're looking for is this yellowing in between the ribs of the leaves. It's pretty clear and pretty obvious. You're also going to get distortion of the new leaves and distortion around the edge and stunting of the growth, which I've already seen in mine because they should be about 7 foot tall by now and they're about 4 foot tall. Now, this is Musifolia. It produces lots of beautiful dark green and chocolate coloured foliage. It doesn't, however, produce many flowers. This is one of the cannas that doesn't produce a lot of flowers. It does flower, but it doesn't produce a lot of flowers. Another symptom of Canna virus in the flowers is you can get white breaks or white mottling on your flowers as well. But you can see there, stark reality. That plant is just going to get weaker and weaker and weaker and possibly infect the others. So it has to go. So there we go, the Canna virus. I might seem a bit sad in this video, and I am sad. I love these cannas. They've been brilliant, but unfortunately I've lost them all. I hope you found that useful and informative, despite the fact that it's not brilliant news for the cannas. Don't forget, I've signposted the resources in the description box below this video. And you can also buy my tools. And I'll see you soon for some more Canna virus adventures. Don't think that works really, does it? Bye for now.